Good morning, and thank you, Chairman, for giving a very extended biodata of me. I'm not sure I deserve all those compliments from you all. But anyway, good morning, and thanks, STI, for giving me this chance to present my views, whatever views I do have in my mind, how I look at the sugar industry, the past, the present, and the future. We generally differ in opinion. You may not be subscribing with my views all the time, and you should not be. Because everybody has got its own style, own views, own thoughts, my own style of looking at the sugar industry, and I am not the last word. So you are not going to subscribe to my views, I know. But this is my view, and I have the liberty of expressing my views. You can always differ in opinion, you can always give your suggestions on that one. But the aim, objective, goal is common. How to take this industry forward. Now coming to the sugar industry, because all the time one thing is very common for all of us. Again, the people may raise their eyebrows because I am talking about sugar industry not doing it all the times. But again, this is my perception because I am living in this industry from the last more than 3 decades. I was almost born in a carbonation sugar factory I started my journey from that place in a carbonation sugar factory, traveled to sulfitation, then to refinery. So I do have experience of working in all the 3 types of the sugar factories, which generally we produce the plantation white sugar, we talk about the raw sugar or the refined sugar. So one thing is very common, we are always facing the issues of economic sustainability. We are talking about one thing. If you ask anybody to define the sugar industry, how you define the sugar industry? It depends upon to whom you are addressing the question. If you are asking this question to a farmer, he will say it is a very problematic industry because we are not getting our payments. If you ask this question from a miller, he will answer, his answer will be a different answer. He will say, no, we are always running in, you know, red. We are not having the profits all the time. But the sustainability is lacking. If you ask to a common man, he will say, this industry is very problematic. You are hitting the headlines of the newspapers every day, but not for good reasons. If you ask a student from my institute or from any other institute in this country, he will say, sir, job potential achha nahi hai, and we are not getting the good pay packages all the time. For me, it is an industry which is of glorious uncertainties. Sometime I equate it with the game of cricket, where you know you don't know what is going to happen till the last ball is bowled. So bahut sari definitions, more than you know the mouth, we can have the definitions of the sugar industry. Bahut shaukeen to nahi hu, lekin hindi filmon mein kabhi kabhi aisa lagta hai ki kuch aisi cheeze hain. Fir again you can differ with my opinion because I have been to this industry from the last more than 3 decades. बड़े बड़े स्टॉलवर्ट्स यहाँ पे बैठे हैं, दानी साहब बैठे हुए हैं, भगत साहब बैठे हैं, तमक साहब बैठे हैं, डॉक्टर डोंगरे बैठे हुए हैं, उन्होंने सबने, सुंदरम साहब हैं, तो मेरे से बेहतर तरीके से आपने इस इंडस्ट्री को देखना होगा. लेकिन मैंने जितनी भी इंडस्ट्री को देखने की कोशिश की है, बहुत करीब से देखने की कोशिश की है. सो माई परसेप्शन गोज विद यू नो द लिरिक्स ऑफ ए सॉन्ग. राज कपूर बड़े फेमस एक्टर हुए हैं और उनकी एक पिक्चर का गाना है, तो वो मैं आपके साथ शेयर करना चाहता था.
मरना यहाँ इसके सिवा जाना कहाँ.
वी आर इन दिस इंडस्ट्री फॉर द सो मेनी इयर्स, वी लव इट, एंड वंस यू आर इन लव विद समवन यू कैन नॉट गेट इट, गेट आउट ऑफ इट. जब आप चाहें आप आवाज दें, नेशनल शुगर इंस्टीट्यूट इज देयर, वी आर देयर टू टेक यू आउट फ्रॉम दिस ऑल दिस ग्लट. तो मेरे जहन के बहुत करीब है ये गाना कि हम कहीं भी रहेंगे लेकिन इंडस्ट्री के बहुत पास रहेंगे तो जीना यहां मरना यहां वी आर इन दिस इंडस्ट्री वी डू हैव अ पैशन वी डू हैव अ लव फॉर इट एंड वी नेवर वांट टू कम आउट फ्रॉम दिस पैशन और लव एंड वी आर देयर टू लव दिस इंडस्ट्री कंटिन्यू टू लव दिस इंडस्ट्री सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द इंपॉर्टेंट कंसिडरेशन बिकॉज माई राइट विल बी योर लेफ्ट यू वुड लाइक टू लिव इट एंड योर लेफ्ट वट यू वॉन्ट टू लेफ्ट विल बी राइट फॉर मी सो यू हैव टू चूज बिटवीन द टू वट इज राइट एंड वट इज wrong for me the important considerations will be surplus sugar production we are having more sugar since 2017-18 it is not a new thing for you you all know how much sugar we are producing sugar is going to these are the you know the key factors the key issues the production is likely to remain surplus during the forthcoming crushing season also so you are going to end up with a lot of sugar in your godowns to the extent of around your consumption of more than 6 months, around 6.5 months, because you are going to end up with around 14.6 million tons of the sugar. You may differ in the statistics because I have taken export of around 3 million tons. You may be talking about 3.3 million tons. But in nutshell, we are going to end up with huge stocks. Sugar exports are still tougher in spite of all the hard work done by the government. They are giving, you know, the MIEP and the quote, the financial assistance and everything, but still we could not achieve the benchmark of 5 million tons and we are still to the extent of around 3.3 million tons. So they are going to be tougher and they are, you know, stringent warnings from the WTO also, the people who are associated with that, they know these are going to be tougher. Sugar prices, they are stable, but yet not lucrative because you want still better prices. In spite of the MSP, the minimum selling price, you need better prices, and very important is still you are struggling with the sugarcane price fixation mechanism, an issue which needs to be addressed. Now, what is the way forward? Utilization of the byproduct, EBP-10, the savior, the ethanol, the savior, it is going to play a major role. Bagasse-based cogeneration, I will come to the subsequent graphics, it's losing charm. Everybody is talking about this bagasse-based cogeneration is not lucrative and you are going to face stiff challenges from the power tariffs which are being offered by the non-conventional energy resources. So how you look at the sugar industry? So you will come to your topic, but I will come to my style of looking at the sugar industry. I want a smart sugar industry. Today you may not subscribe to my views because how it can be done or the God will give you an industry which is very smart. But you have to be a visionary. You have to look the sugar industry by 10 years from now. So you are talking about smartphones, you are talking about smart cities, you are talking about smart trains, you are talking about anything and everything which is smart. So you have to look sugar industry as a smart sugar industry, having sugar cane which is smart, you are having smart processing techniques and smart techniques for harnessing the potential of byproducts in an innovative manner. This is the scenario which is I'm going to present before you because you can see from the last 3 years we are producing more than what we consume as far as the sugar is concerned and we are having more sugars in our godowns once we opened this season 2018-19 and we are going to have still more sugar in our godowns once we end up this season 2018-19 and open the season 2019-20. So the closing balances as on 30th September 2019 are likely to be around 14.62 million tons, which are more than 6.5 months consumption, the domestic consumption of this country. So you can very well speculate, you can very well see what type of situation we are going to face if we do not balance the demand supply position of the sugar in the country. So how we can address the issues? The million dollar question is because a lot of brainstorming we are doing, a lot of seminars, conferences, and this August gathering is here to discuss all these issues in the subsequent sessions also. So issues before these, to me, the three P's are very important. Dr. Rao is not here, otherwise he would have spoken to me why you are entering into all policies and all that. You limit yourself to productivity or product diversification. But since I am trying to play a role in giving the technical inputs for making the policy. So I have deliberately considered three P's: the policy, the productivity of the sugar factories, and the product diversification, or you may call it as a value addition. The first policy, which is known to you, and I think whosoever is concerned with the sugar industry is very vocal on that, crying for that, because in this country you are having a fight between the FRP and the SAPs. You are talking about the SAPs. You are having different price fixation mechanism in different states. So that renders a lot of, you know, problems with the different states. The prices of the sugar, they also vary depending upon the cost of the sugar cane. So you want a policy. A few days back we had a meeting with the CACP, and again suggestions were invited, and all the time the people are talking and we people are talking about a logical formula for fixation of the sugarcane price, maybe on the basis of the quality, maybe on the basis of the revenue sharing, because the revenue sharing formula has already been defined by the Dr. Rangarajan committee. So many a times we have heard industry talking about anything which is near to, or maybe a revenue sharing formula which has been near to revenue sharing formula which has been adopted by some of the states also. So this is one reason. This is very important also, and important because we are talking about why Indian sugars are not competitive. The technologists and the engineers, they can have a pat on their back because your qualities are comparable or even better. Quality is not the issue. The issue is the cost of the sugar. And why the cost of the Indian sugar is higher? It is not because your conversion cost is higher, because the cost of the sugarcane is very higher. You can look at the graphic where I have deliberately shown the other major sugar producing countries like Thailand, the Brazil and the Australia. The cane costs are hovering around $24 to $27 per ton of cane, where the cane cost in India is around 1.5 to 1.6 times the cost of the sugarcane, which is prevailing in these three major countries, Thailand, Brazil and Australia. As compared to $24 to $27 per ton of the cane cost is somewhere around 42, 43. You can have the precise calculation based on the recoveries and the FRP. But mota mota main batana chahta tha ki this is the prime reason where we are lacking and why we are not globally competitive, because of the higher cane cost. So we have to have a logical formula. We have to have a reasonable sugarcane price fixation mechanism, which is to be applied on pan-India basis. Maybe on quality, maybe on revenue sharing, and that brainstorming can always be done. There are many, you know, regulations to the byproducts. So I'm not going to discuss all those regulations, but I've gone for underlining the important issues. You know the regulations because you people are working in the sugar industry, and you know the type of the stringent controls sometimes exercised by the state governments, not talking about the central government, but the as far as the byproduct is concerned, there are stiffer regulations from the state governments. Somebody be the government, central government may be issuing an advisory, but the state governments may not be subscribing to those advisories and following those instructions, because we do have a federal form of the government ultimately. So we have taken call in these matters. Just wanted to underline the issues that, yes, on behalf of you or as a common cause, we have taken a call in these matters. The rate of ethanol for partial or full diversion of cane juice need to be revisited. Why there should be any differential in the prices of the ethanol which has been derived due to full diversion or partial diversion of the sugarcane juice? This issue has been taken up, and the government is also serious, and I hope some solution will emerge, whether we should have the same price or near to the price of the full diversion of the sugarcane juice. So this issue needs to be revisited. And since, you know, you are talking about full cane juice diversion, so you also know if you divert your whole cane juice, the magnitude of the distillery which you require. If you are having a sugar factory of around 5,000 TCD, and if you are going to divert whole of the sugarcane juice, you need a distillery of around 350 KLPD. So you need investments. And you will make investments only when you do have the policy assurance. If you have got a policy for alcohol year, from 1st of December to 30th of the November, and you are talking about the full diversion of the sugarcane juice, I am not sure how many of you are going to make the capital investment. So you need a policy assurance, you need a stable policy, and for a reasonable period of time, so that you can at least recover the amount which you have invested. This was my second point, because to the best of my understanding, and just to inform you also, for the first time, the Government of India organized a brainstorming session with the mill owners, with the ISMA, National Federations, and all that. Many of us were present during that brainstorming session. And all these issues were flagged during that brainstorming session, that industry requires all this. One other question which was put up by me, since we are talking about the bagasse-based cogeneration, which is not very lucrative now, and you are having stiff challenges, in times to come, you may be having a pile of the bagasse lying with you. So what to do? You need options. You need options. The options will come. It will take time. It will require technology intervention. It will require capital investment. Lekin tab tak kya karein? Since we have made the capital investment on bagasse-based cogeneration, then what to do? So I suggested, like we do have minimum selling price of the sugar, or we do have the price fixation mechanism for ethanol, can we have something like minimum price or the floor price for the bagasse-based power also? The question is, ki this is a state government subject, but we requested the central government, at least you can think over the issue and you can issue an advisory to the state government that like sugar and ethanol, can we have something like floor price for the bagasse also? Trade policy, you people understand what is happening. The government is also very keen, serious, because they also know the quantum of the sugar which you are carrying in your godowns. But you have to look into the WTO regulations also. So I just want to give you a signal. The government is more than proactive. They are trying to give you all the financial assistance which is possible without inviting the attention or making any infringements in the WTO regulations. Environmental issues, as far as the policy is concerned, environmental issues are again of major concern, because the people who are sitting in the Gangetic plains in the Ganga basin, they are facing the music because of various reasons, the Clean Ganga Mission or the Namami Gange or whatever you call it. And unko malum bhi hai ki kitni environmental penalties unhone they have received. So these are going to be, you know, few issues, because the CPCB is now talking about the freshwater consumption. They are talking about the 3 R's, the reduce, reuse and recycle philosophy, measurements of everything and anything. The freshwater consumption, the discharges, the effluent generation or the wastewater generation from each and every source, from each unit operations, everything is to be measured. So they need measurement of each and everything. Unless you measure, you cannot improve, because you are hypothetical. You are talking about, I discharge this much, I discharge this much. This is all theoretical, because you are not measuring. So everything is to be measured. Unless you measure it, you cannot improve. And then you have to go for creation of an environmental cell. I am happy that many of the sugar factories in the subtropical region have now gone for the creation of the environmental cell. So the keywords for me, as far as the environmental issues are concerned, is still, yesterday I was talking about, still we do not have, to the best of my knowledge, jahan tak mere apne gyan ka prashn hai, wahan tak mujhe nahi malum ki we do have any discharge norms if we go for a distillery which is based on the cane juice. So we have to have the discharge norms for the cane juice based distilleries, although we have already written to the Central Pollution Control Board and to the Government of India as well. Because you do have a specification for the grain-based distilleries, you do have a specification for the molasses-based distilleries, so you have to have the discharge norms for the cane juice-based distilleries also. And can we have some more technologies for treatment of the effluents, because CSIR is doing, and many other people are doing, IIT Kharagpur is doing, so many people are working on alternate technologies. So we have to take this forward beyond incineration and biocomposting, talking about again fertility irrigation and many more technologies which can be developed and can be implemented in consultation with the Central Pollution Control Board and the State Pollution Control Boards. So this is an issue which I wanted to flag. And this again, seldom we are talking about this very important point. Arey bhai, ganna ki definition kya hai? Pehle to mujhe ye batao. What is the definition of the sugar cane? The FRP says 275 rupees a quintal for a sugar recovery of 10. It means sugar cane is one which gives you a sugar recovery of 10. If your losses are to the extent of 1.8 or 2, your pole percentage should be 11.8 or 12. If somebody is getting a recovery of less than 10 and the losses are 1.8 or 2, can you define it as a sugar cane? So there is no definition of the sugar cane. Sugar cane is one which contains 15, 14, 12, 13% of the sucrose and rest is the politics. So definition to us tarike se ho gai. We are not talking about sugar cane. Aap ganne ke kitne jhagde hote hain. The people know it. Because in Maharashtra or Karnataka or elsewhere you are having the factories are performing the harvesting and the transport. But in the subtropical region where the UP, the Bihar, the Haryana, the Punjab, the Uttaranchal is there, or even in Madhya Pradesh we are talking about, what quantity of the extraneous matter you are having in the sugar cane? And what is the deduction percent allowed? 1%? Even if you go by the manual harvesting, kisan, the farmer is very simple, but he is equally smart also. Aapko to tol ke lena, it is on the basis of the weight, whether you get a sugar cane or you get the extraneous material, he is going to get the same price. So 1% kyun? Ye norm kab aaya tha? In 60s, when a scheme was pronounced by the central government and a survey was carried out, how much deduction is to be allowed? 1%, 1.5%, 2%, 0.5%. Now, since you are getting sugar cane from two different sources, one is manually harvested and other is the mechanically harvested. And to the best of my knowledge and my understanding, you are getting a lot of trash and extraneous matter in the mechanically harvested sugar cane. Now, why the factory should be penalized? So, I think some study, maybe a joint study between the industry and the institutes, or a sort of tripartite arrangement where the government is there and the state government or the central government is there, the institutes are there or the factories are there, they can carry out a study and they can come out with a document on that. What should be the extent of deduction? In case of the manual harvesting, it should not be less than 2%. Realistic, you have to be realistic. Aap ganna nahi, jab crush karenge, to extraneous matter crush karenge, to recovery kahan se aayegi? It is a very straight line equation. If you are not having the sugar cane and you are having the extraneous matter, if it exceeds by 1%, how much recovery loss will be there? Aap sab jante hain. But you have to raise this question and we have to be vocal. If there are two systems in vogue for harvesting the sugar cane, manual or mechanical, or you call it the extent of deduction, you have to be realistic. Again, you are with the ethanol, you are almost breathing now. The factories who are having the ethanol, you are breathing. Sugar is not lucrative, prices are stable, and in times to come, because you are going to have a lot of carryovers, I don't know how the system is going to move around, because I am not a jyotishi nahi hu, bhavishyavetta nahi hu, and I am not a policy maker that way. Again, I say, the sugar industry is a game of glorious uncertainties. Nahi malum ki kal ko kya hoga. But the sugar industry is such an industry at present. It is facing situation which is to be taken care with the financial assistance from the government only. So I wish this financial assistance to continue. Government is thinking of that. They are working on that. And I hope in times to come you are going to listen more policies how to incentivize the sugar industry as a whole through various routes. Now we can talk something about the productivity, because moving ahead from the policy, because policy is not my forte. I can talk something on productivity, because my target is again the smart gain. How much you know my target should be, the yield up. Once I am talking about anything average, it is on all India basis, not talking specifically about any state. You can see the variations in the productivity of sugarcane across the various sugar producing states, 110 to down 50 or 55 tons per hectare. Same is happening with the pole percent cane also. So such heterogeneity in the sugarcane productivity is there. So at least we have to settle down at some place. What should be our target? A cane yield of not less than 100 tons per hectare? A recovery or pole percent cane not less than 12 or 13? So since you are getting more than 10 recoveries, average recovery of more than 10, your target should be the pole percent cane should not be less than 13, and your yield should be more than 100, maybe 100 or 120 tons per hectare. So my keywords again for a smart cane will be not talking about the yield alone, not talking about the pole percent cane in isolation, talking about the sugar per hectare. The yield should be higher, the pole percent cane should be higher, in totality the sugar per hectare should be higher. Climate change, because we are talking about the climate change, the type of the rainfalls we are having, the drought conditions, the irrigation water requirements, and you know, the increasing temperatures. So we have to have sugarcane varieties which can withstand the climate change, the varieties which can withstand the various biotic and abiotic stresses, and requiring lesser inputs of fertilizers or irrigation water. There should also be, you know, varieties who do not deteriorate at a faster pace after harvest. So the post-harvest deterioration rates should be lesser. So I would like to see the sugarcane varieties in times to come, the varieties to be termed as the smart canes. This picture is, you know, again something doing with the productivity at the factory levels, where we are talking about, generally we people in sugar technologies, they talk about the RME or the RBHEs or the losses or the average recovery. Again, you can see lot of heterogeneity in the total sugar losses. So what should be the benchmark? The sugar losses not more than 1.8. What should be the average recovery? I already spoken, it should be more than 11. What should be the lime and sulfur consumptions? Because these are the two basic or the two primary process chemicals which you are using in your sugar factories. You can see the peaks and the valleys. So you should benchmark your consumptions of the primary process chemicals. Lime may be around 0.15% on cane. Sulfur consumption not exceeding 0.05% on cane. So like that, you can have the benchmarking of your consumption of the primary process chemicals. And then smart processing involves each and everything. Apart from pole percent cane, sugar losses, RME, RBHE, the various input cost, we may talk about the chemical cost, manpower cost, repair and maintenance cost, so on and so forth. The steam consumptions. Again, I am not having the graphic with me to show you the variation in the steam consumption and power consumption from one factory to another or from one zone to another. But we have to go in for benchmarking of these performance parameters as well. Maybe a very realistic figure, 22 kilowatt per TCS the people are talking about, or 20 kilowatt per TCS the people are talking about, or 36% on cane, or now we are talking about 28 or 30% on cane. But this 28% or 30% on cane or 36% on cane should be considering the highest recoveries, higher imbibition water, and the higher mesquit percent on cane also. Sometime what is happening, I have seen this year, from the last 2 years, I am experiencing in UP, or particularly in the state of UP, where the recoveries have gone up. Your mesquit percent cane has also gone up. Now the people are talking about our steam consumption has increased, not bothering about how much mesquite percent cane has increased. And one thing which is very important for all of us, generally problem is how we calculate the capacities. We generally calculate capacities on the basis of the average values. If you go to a sugar factories, please excuse me, you may be doing the correct estimations, but in many of the sugar factories I have seen, A mesquite percent cane, he will come out with the average value, 28, B, 12, C, 8, and you know, this is the mesquite percent cane. On the basis of that, he will derive the total capacity calculations at the pan, crystallizer or centrifugalization station and the steam consumption. Forgetting about the extremes, because during the peak recovery period, you must be having a very high mesquite percent cane. May not be 28, maybe 30, 31, B mesquite 13, 14, C mesquite higher, or you may be boiling a C1 mesquite also. So you have to be realistic and practical in calculating your capacities for pan stations, crystallizer station, elsewhere, and when deciding on what type of steam consumption you can have in your sugar factories. So you need many more. You need smart processing techniques. I will come to the, you know, the various other options available, not talking about the sulfitation process, which is at least I am not very fond of. So I do have my own views on that one. But you need many more. At least I am not going into the details of these technologies. But just to have a brainstorming, just a food for thought for you people. Kya kar sakte hain, what we can do? Still, we should continue with the milling system. We talk a lot about conventional mill, mill with GRPF, mill with TRPF, mill with GRPF and TRPF, and two roller mill, three roller mill, TRF, each and everything. Can we have, you know, a study on milling versus diffusion? Because you can raise many questions. You can deliberate on advantages and disadvantages of the diffusers, the benefits of the milling system or the benefits of the diffuser system, but you have to draw a balance. Because once, now we are having the installations of the diffusers also. And we are talking about the RMEs. We are talking about the lower capital expenditure. We are also talking about lower operating expenditure for the diffusers. We are also talking about 30-40% lower power consumption. We are also talking about the lower civil cost, and diffusers can be installed outside the factory. So if there are so many advantages, the claimed advantages are there. Claimed advantages. And now we do have more than 10 installations of the diffusers. So can we think this diffusers going to replace the conventional milling system, or we should think on, or we should deliberate on, or we should brainstorm on these two technologies, milling versus diffusion, not talking about the diffusers which were installed 50 years back in the country where the cane preparation was very poor, steam consumptions were very high. Now we are into an era where we are having the preparatory index of 88 or 90 or even more, and we are having the steam consumption where we can afford to have diluted juices for processing. So this is in the present era where we can have a, you know, discussion on this technology. Then this, you know, alternate technology we are always talking about, because I am allergic to this sulfitation process, and all the time I am talking about a process, because to me the best route is the raw refined route. If you cannot have the raw refined route, at least you have a process where you are going to have a sugar with low sulfur content and the quality which is equivalent to the plantation wide sugar you can produce in the country, because you are having a lot of CO2. Dr. Dongre has carried out the work on this. The institute has also carried out a work on how to utilize the carbon dioxide which is coming out from the fermenters, using it as a clarificant, because in the past we used to have the carbonation process, and at that point of time we used to have the lime kilns. So not requiring any lime kilns, can we have the CO2 from the fermenters using it as a clarificant, or using it as a clarificant during the melt clarification in refineries also? Because at present, हमारे यहाँ जितनी भी केसरवानी साहब ने फैक्ट्री लगवाई है, मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर बेस्ड ऑन द फॉस्फोफ्लोटेशन प्रोसेस, बट एल्सवेयर द फैक्ट्रीज और द रिफाइनरीज आर वर्किंग ऑन कार्बोनेशन प्रोसेस ऑल्सो. सो कैन वी हैव अ ट्राई ऑन दैट? सो दिस इज अ, यू नो, अगेन अ इशू विच आई वॉन्टेड टू फ्लैग. अपार्ट फ्रॉम रॉ रिफाइंड रूट, कैन वी हैव अदर टेक्नोलॉजीज, अदर प्रोसेसेस, कॉस्ट इकोनॉमिक, कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव processes where we can have the plantation white sugar with low or no sulfur content? Again, you know, there is a system of sulfitation. The the students of sugar technology courses, they know this is the query system of sulfitation. I'm not trying to advocate the system of sulfitation, but there is a system which is known as the query system of sulfitation, which is working satisfactorily in one of the sugar factories in India from years together. ये ऐसा प्रोसेस की बात मैं नहीं कर रहा हूँ जो कि प्रोसेस मैं आज की बात कर रहा हूँ कि which has been installed, implemented and being working in a sugar factory from few years. It is working from years together. और अगर आप हॉर्निक का वॉल्यूम वन खोलें तो शायद उन्होंने आज से इसको कितनी शताब मतलब दशकों पहले उन्होंने इस चीज को लिखा था कि you can go with a query system जहाँ पे कि you can have the sulfitation. Why you need a sulfitation which is named as the query system? Because you save in space and you save in power. मैं आपको उसको I'm going to show you the slide. Because for a 6000 TCD factory, you need around 106 kilowatt or 105 kilowatt of the power, and that system of sulfitation occupies around 200 square meter of the floor area. But if you go with this system, you require only 30 kilowatt of the power and occupies only 90 square meter of the floor area. So you are saving in power by around 65% to 70%, and you are saving in the floor space by around 50%. So this is the system which is working in one of the sugar factories, to be precisely named as Andhra Sugars, from the years together. So if we are following the sulfitation process and we are not ready to change, so at least we can try this system where we can save in space, where we can save in power. So this is another process or other technique which I wanted to flag today before you. Now talking about, you know, still you are continuing with the sulfitation process and you are aspiring for producing very good quality of the sugar. Because generally whenever we are talking about quality of the sugar, we are talking of sugar which is having a certain ICMSA value, color of certain ICMSA value, maybe less than 100, or we may talking about the SO2 content which should be less than 20. Now, you are having the clarification of the sugarcane juice by conventional method. You are talking about the double sulfitation process. Now agreed, I am subscribing to your views only. Please continue, because you have made the capital investment. You can continue with your system of the sulfitation. But can we have something like pre-clarification of the juice? What we did, we tried, and it has been tried in many countries and lot of data is available. Pre-clarification of the sugarcane juice means not putting all the load on the clarification process, the conventional clarification process. But you are trying to take out some of the non-sugars before you go for the liming and sulfitation. So the one technique may be, you know, heating, adding flocculant and centrifuging it. So once you centrifuge it, lot of, you know, impurities, they come out from the juices. To the extent of around coral removal is to the extent of around 30% to 35%, the turbidity removal is to the extent of 80% to 85%. It means once you take out the non-sugars or these impurities from the sugarcane juice prior to the sulfitation process, you are putting lesser load on the sulfitation process, requiring lesser process chemicals, and then you are going to have a good quality of the sugar, having better color and low sulfur content. So pre-clarification may be by centrifugation, or Suviron is there, they have come out with a hot raw juice screening, and they claim that your color of the sugar can reduce by your color of your sugar can reduce by 10% to 15% or 10% to 15% ICMSA. In nutshell, the aim is same, putting lesser load on main clarification process, trying to take out turbid material, collider material, or whatever you can remove by heat treatment and filtration before you put for subsequent processing. So in pursuit of making good quality of the sugar, you can go in for pre-clarification of the, in totality you have to see what are the advantages, disadvantages, what extra effort you are supposed to make, and what is the economics of the system. But this is worth trying, and we can see in our sugar factories what are the advantages of all these things. The last but not the least in the technology part is the super short retention time clarifiers. All of us know only few factories have got SRTs, because we are very apprehensive about the quality of the clear juice which is coming out. So we, by and large, I think 99 or more than 99.9% of the sugar factories are using the conventional rapid ore clarifiers, having a retention time of 2.5 hours. All of us know, all the sugar technologists, sugar engineers, anybody who is associated with the sugar factory knows, the sugar should be out by the shortest route. The total processing of sugar or sugarcane juice or the beet juice depends upon three parameters only: pH, temperature and retention. More is the retention, more problems you are inviting. The sugar should be out by the shortest route. So we are talking about clarifiers working on 1.5 hours, 2 hours, 2.5 hours, like that. So this gave, you know, advent of the short retention time clarifier, but they are not very popular in India because we are making the plantation white sugar. Whosoever is having the short retention time clarifier, they have installed where they are having the raw sugars. So they are making the raw sugars, it is not going to affect them and they are melting it. But do you think the short retention time clarifier cannot give good quality of the juice? Theoretically, if I go by the Stokes law, if I go by the rate of the settling, if I go by the rate of settling this much inch per minute, do you think how much time we require for our juices to settle? We need only 6 minutes. It is not the high time and I cannot elaborate on that. But if you go by the calculations, if you go by the logic, if you go by the chemical engineering of that one, your juices require only 6 minutes for settling of the impurities. And we are using the clarifiers which are working on 2 or 2.5 hours. The problem initially was we are not having very stabilized flow. Even the SRTs of the short retention time clarifiers which are working in the sugar industry are working satisfactorily because they are having the proper automation in each and every respect. From juice flow to flocculant flow, everything. And maintenance of the temperature as well. Many advantages are there of the short retention time clarifiers. Some of the short retention time clarifiers which are working in the sugar industry are having a retention time of around 45 minutes or an hour. We tried, because I had a discussion with Peter Rain from South Africa, and we worked on a short, super short retention time clarifier working not on 6 minutes, not on 45 minutes, but 15 minutes. It is an inclined plate, a sort of, you know, lamella clarifier, improvised version of the lamella clarifier, inclined plate clarifier, and you can see the results. It is working in our experimental sugar factory, which is a 100 TCD plant, satisfactorily. So we are, you know, already having a taste of this clarifier. Now it is you to take it forward. So this technology, this system, this clarifier has got a promise. If you can have a settling in 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, and if you can get a quality of the juice which is comparable with the conventional clarifiers, you are going to save many things. Lesser sugar loss, lesser color development, lesser heat loss, many advantages, and the capital cost will be much lesser. So look at the keywords. Look at the keywords. The capital cost will be lesser. The sugar loss will be lesser. The heat loss will be lesser. And the color development will be lesser. The only thing is, you will ask me what we need. We need attitude. Wo humko karna padega. Somebody has to bell the cat. Bani hui cheez aapke samne rakhi hai. You know your baby well. You know how to take it forward. But somebody has to come forward. So isko karna padega. This is an issue. Again, I wanted to place it before you for your views and discussions. Aur ye cheez to meri zindagi ke saath hi jayegi, because I always look for a very clean, green process of sugar production. To hell with this sulfitation process. Why we are into this sulfitation process even today? This is not an environment-friendly process. You are importing sulfur. You are generating SO2 gas. You are pouring tons of SO2 gas into the atmosphere. You are inviting atmospheric corrosion. You are inviting corrosion of the process equipments. You are having higher SO2 content or the sulfur content in your sugars. But even then, you do have a fancy for going for or still adopting or going on or continuing with the sulfitation process. Today we do have the technologies, we do have the steam economy devices, we do have the technology at place. Arey, wo din to chale gaye na, when we used to have a steam consumption of 60-65%, 50-55%, 40-45%. Today we are talking about steam consumption in refinery to the extent of 40 or 41%. Why you are afraid of that then now? Why you are not converting? केसरवानी साहब को मैं तो बार बार बुलाता हूँ और कहता हूँ कि प्रवचन कर रहे हैं, यू शुड कम टू माई इंस्टीट्यूट. आई ऑल यू नो ईच एंड एवरी ईयर आई एम कॉलिंग पीपल लाइक अनूप केसरवानी जी टू माई इंस्टीट्यूट टू एजुकेट द स्टूडेंट्स कि भाई सितारों से आगे और भी चीजें देखो. सल्फिटेशन प्रोसेस तो हमने तो वो हॉर्निक की किताब की फोटो कापी पढ़ ली, अब तुम भी इसको मत पढ़ते चलो, ये नई किताब पढ़ो और देखो कि रॉ रिफाइंड या कोई और चीजें क्या हैं. What are the better options? What are the options before you? And the sugar, you know, which you are going to produce through raw refined route or some other route, you look at the quality, look at the market requirement, look at the consumer behavior. Aaj culture kitna change ho gaya hai. You have to look into the market dynamics. Jo main kal baat bol raha tha, I was speaking on this quality of the sugar yesterday also. Why you are still bagging the sugar in 50 kg bags? Once you go for a raw refined route, you open many other areas because the people will talk about the refined sugar, the people will talk about the pharmaceutical sugar, the people will talk about the liquid sugar, the people will talk about the many fortified flavor sugars as well, many special sugars. So my vote will go for a process which is greener, which is cleaner, which is environment friendly and which can fetch me sugar of better quality and which will open, you know, areas for making many other type of the sugars which can fetch me some good prices. I can go for the value addition and I can go for the branding of my sugars. So many type of the sugars you can see. You can have many more pictures from the Google or from the net. Then, you know, the third, I was talking about the product diversification or the value addition as we call nowadays. Because all the time we are talking about, you know, one thing, value addition, because we are not getting enough revenues and we are talking about the revenue pots. I am interested in revenue pot. How much revenue is coming from sugar? How much revenue is coming from other sources? We are hugely dependent. Somebody was addressing this issue yesterday and he said, we are hugely dependent upon sugar and will remain dependent on the sugar heavily. Why? People were quoting many names. You also can, you can also quote various names. British Sugars, Cogen Sugar, Mitrafol Sugars. I think Tamak Sahab abhi Mitrafol hoke aaye hain. Learn lesson. Seekhne mein koi chota aur koi bada nahi ho jata. Aap apne sabse chote se bhi seekhte hain. This is again a common cause. We are not the last word. You may be intelligent, but you are not the only intelligent. इस बात को जिस दिन हम इसको समझ लेंगे, आत्मसात कर लेंगे, उस दिन हम आगे बढ़ जाएंगे. सबसे पहली चीज ये होती है, अगर मैं कहूंगा कि ये वी कैन प्रोड्यूस दिस, वो दूसरा कहेगा वो क्यों नहीं. अरे भाई तुम 50 साल से यही कर लेते, उसको भी क्यों नहीं किया. अगर ये करने को कह रहा है तो कम से कम इसी को कर लो. तो क्रिटिसिज्म फॉर द सेक ऑफ क्रिटिसिज्म इज नॉट गुड. Criticism for the sake of improvement is welcome. Because we are enjoying this platform for a very common cause. We are earning our bread and butter through this sugar industry. How we can take this industry forward? And once we sit together again, we should not talk about the economic sustainability anymore. We should talk about now industry is sustainable. So product diversification, because the savior is, you know, again, aap sab jante hain what is happening in the sugar industry. We are talking about the major components fetching us the revenues. If you sell your bagasse, you sell your molasses, 90% almost revenues are coming from the sugar and 10% of the revenues are coming from byproducts. So you are hugely dependent on sugar. Once you go for ethanol, you go for the power generation, your revenues are to the extent of around 20% from other sources and 80% from the sugar. Your dependency on sugar reduces. But as you are claiming As you do have the examples of other companies like British Sugar, Cogen Sugars, Mithilfold Sugars and many more, or you do have some ideas in your mind that we can diversify, to me there should be a realistic balance that around 35% of the revenue should come from other sources and 65% of the revenue should come from the sugar only. So you are lesser dependent upon the revenues from the sugar. So any volatility in the prices of the sugar, you will have a cushion. You will not run to the government that, you know, look, sugar prices have gone down, I need your financial assistance. Because you will be having a cushion with you, because 35% of the revenues then will be coming from other sources. So we have to look into that important area, diversifying from the normal sugar, diversifying from the use of byproducts or the co-products in the conventional manner, thinking beyond. इसके बारे में कोई ऐसी चीज नहीं है जो कि आप नहीं जानते हो, co-generation. The only thing which I wanted to flag is, again, since we do have a large infrastructure, large areas with the sugar industry, looking to the geographic locations, somebody may be sitting in the coastal area, somebody may be sitting in the tropical region, subtropical region, depending upon the your location, can we have hybrid systems in the sugar industry? Because the government is very keen incentivizing also. So can we have biomass-based power generation, solar power and wind power or anything? Anything. We are also nowadays, we are talking about the production of the, because all the time we are talking about the energy from the sugar industry. So nowadays we are, at least we have started and we have made some progress in this area also. Conventionally we use filter cake or the press mud for production of the biocompost, or it is a problematic area because I have seen many biocompost yards, so it is an area of concern for all of us. Sometimes the disposal of the press mud is a problem. So can we have, you know, the biomethane or the bio-CNG from filter cake? Again, this has been done by many people. Even in the institute, we are having a pilot plant trial with the help of ISJEC. They were kind enough to give us the financial assistance for setting up that plant. So we are having a biomethanation plant. We are using the filter cake and spent wash or the farmyard manure, anything, different 10 combinations we have tried, and we are having a pilot plant. So can we have, you know, something like generation or production of the biomethane or bio-CNG from the filter cake and sugar industry? Because now we are having a business model by the oil marketing companies before us, where they are given a price of 48 rupees 30 paisa per kg of the CNG. And we had a road show in February or March, where Professor Biochemistry Dr. Seema Parvashi is there. She gave a presentation on that. Again, we are going to have a presentation in some other session on this production of the biomethane and bio-CNG, where you can get an idea about the economics of the system also, because around 25 to 30 kg of the filter cake gives you around 1 kg of the bio-CNG or the biomethane. So biogas or biomethane or bio-CNG, whatever. If you want to use it for the cooking purposes, you can have it as a biogas. If you want to use it as an automotive fuel, you can go for the biomethane or bio-CNG having a methane content of around 95%, 96%, 97%. So that can be improved depending upon the scrubbing systems. So this is another area where sugar factories can target and they can earn revenues. Again, ethanol. So this is the scenario which is, you know, hum logon ke saath kya hota hai ki all the time we are traveling and doing all these provisions all the time. So many of the slides we are repeating. आपने इसको सुना होगा कि यार ये हर बार वही स्लाइड लेके आ जाते हैं, हर बार वही बताते हैं, बट दिस इज द, यू नो, बियॉन्ड माय कंट्रोल, बिकॉज ऑल द टाइम इफ यू आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द इथेनॉल, यू आर सपोज टू शो दीज ग्राफिक्स, दीज स्लाइड्स, जस्ट टू ब्रीफ यू ऑन व्हाट इज हैपनिंग. फॉर 10% ऑफ द, यू नो, द ब्लेंडिंग, इफ यू गो बाई द ईयर 2018-19, यू कैन सी यू नीड अराउंड 3,300 मिलियन लीटर्स ऑफ द इथेनॉल. If you go for a blending of around 20%, you need around 6,600 million liters of the ethanol. This will grow with time and this will keep on increasing. 80% of our requirement we are meeting through imports. I am not going to talk about why this ethanol is very important for us, because all of you know clean, green, energy security, foreign exchange, everything, blah, blah, blah. The only thing is I am interested to know, and I want to convince myself, if we need 3,000 million liters, 330 crore liter ethanol agar mujhe chahiye for 10% of the blending, or 6,060 crore liters of the ethanol, from where it will come? Because with my stretch of imagination, how much molasses you produce? Because sometimes statistics is a matter of convenience, how you put the statistics. आप चीजों को घुमा देते हैं, आप बता देंगे नहीं जी बहुत इथेनॉल है, बहुत मोलासेस है. फ्रॉम वेयर द मोलासेस विल कम? यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग ओनली 11 टू 13 मिलियन टन्स ऑफ द मोलासेस पर ईयर. इफ यू टेक एन एवरेज यील्ड ऑफ 235 लीटर्स पर टन ऑफ द मोलासेस, यू आर गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस अराउंड 3000 मिलियन लीटर्स और 3300 मिलियन लीटर्स ऑफ द इथेनॉल. यानी कि आप साल में 330 करोड़ लीटर का कुल इथेनॉल बना सकते हैं इफ यू आर बैंकिंग अपॉन मोलासेस. एंड फॉर 10% ऑफ द ब्लेंडिंग योर रिक्वायरमेंट इज एग्जैक्टली द सेम. यानी कि आप मोलासेस रूट से जितना बनाए और सारा का सारा इथेनॉल के लिए दे दें, तब आप 10% ब्लेंडिंग को प्राप्त कर सकेंगे, वो भी जब जबकि आप इस गति से शक्कर बनाएंगे. So now look at the cane crushed is because this year we are talking about production of 33 million tons of the sugar. So if I go by the recovery of 11%, you are going to crush around 300 million metric tons of the sugar cane. So kitna aapko molasses milega? You can see molasses secret will be somewhere around, you know, 13.5 million metric tons. You are going to produce around 3,173 million liters of the ethanol. And you see, your ethanol blending requirements for 10% and 20% are there. So, you see the serial number 3, how much quantity of the ethanol you are diverting for country liquor and other liquor, potable liquors. 1,500. You are going to produce 3,173. You are diverting 1,500 for potable sector. You are left with 1,673, and ethanol required is 3,241. So hardly 50% you are having with you once you are doing the diversion for potable liquor and all that. But why you are getting 7% and 8%, or you are talking about more than that? Because you are getting ethanol from grains also, around 50 crore liters or 500 million liters. And this year, we considered we diverted around 0.5 million tons of the sugar through B-heavy route, yielding around 300 million liters or 30 crore liters of the ethanol. So that way, if you calculate the total ethanol available, it will be 2,473 million liters during the year. So still you are left with 768 million liters or 76 crore liters of the alcohol. So how you are going to achieve the 10% blending of the ethanol in petrol? You cannot do, in spite of the fact that I have considered 50 crore liters from the grain and 300 million liters or 30 crore liters of the ethanol from the B-heavy molasses. So you have to look for new sources. You see the last line of the table, ethanol required from the new sources. Once you are going for 20% blending and aspiring to have more than 6,400 million liters of the ethanol. So you need ethanol from other sources, moving ahead from B-heavy or the conventional route of cane juice diversion and all that. So we have to look for smart distilleries, looking for multi-feed stocks, maybe sugar beet, maybe, you know, grains, the maize, the rice, and all that. We have to look into the economics of that one. You can have many more, you know, value-added products, because we are going to have, presentations on all these topics during this 3 days convention. But just to show you, you can have many such value-added products from the bagasse or from the molasses, or because this is not in air, this is not a rocket science I am talking about. This is all which has been done, which has all has been carried out, which all has been validated, characterized at the laboratory scale or even at the plant scale. From mushroom to bio-CNG to dietary fiber to graphene oxide to ingredients for anti-aging cream to low-calorie sweetener xylitol to many more. So all you know and all you need is your passion, your attitude, and how you are going to take this industry forward. Last but not the least, how I look at the sugar industry. I look at the sugar industry doing all these things and all what is required to make it economically sustainable. And I also look at the sugar industry as a ZFC, zero freshwater consumption industry. This should be our mission, because all the time the Honorable Prime Minister is also worried and he has got his concerns about the depleting water resources. We are having enough water in our sugar cane. So can we convert our sugar factories by 2030 as zero freshwater consumption factories, instead giving water to the society in the form of the potable water? I know we do have immense potential. Kisi cheez ki koi kami nahi hai. We have shown we are, you know, the second largest producer of the sugar, highest consumer, better quality of the sugar. Our sugar machinery manufacturers are doing business in more than 35-40 countries. So we are having a sugar industry of infinite possibilities. We have the all the required ingredients which can take this industry forward, and we can have an economical sustainable industry. Why we cannot succeed? I hope we will succeed, and definitely we will succeed, because I believe in hum honge kamyab. Thank you. Definitely we will succeed. My all good wishes are with all of you. Thank you.